Help Hippo, better than learning from Wikipedia. Help Hippo's previous immunology tutorial explained that the immune system is divided into innate and adaptive components, with the innate cellular quadrant remembered by mono kills granny. Mono kills granny. This current tutorial will explain the histology of mono, that is, monocytes, which are related to macrophages and dendritic cells. Monocytes are in the blood, and once in the tissue, they grow up to be macrophages. Monocytes have a big, kidney-shaped nucleus with a frosted glass cytoplasm. Once a monocyte becomes a macrophage, the macrophage will live for months. Macrophages are known primarily for eating stuff, and cool histology pictures show macrophages in the middle of this phagocytosis, like this macrophage with parasitic protozoa in its belly. After eating, it's as if macrophages poop out a little bit of antigen and put that antigen on their cell surface to tell other immune responders, "There are invaders here! Come, help!" This signaling by sticking pooped out antigen on your surface is done by antigen-presenting cells. While macrophages do a bit of antigen presenting, it's the dendritic cells that are known primarily as antigen presenting cells. Dendritic cells are shaped like trees with many branches. While dendritic cells are known primarily for their antigen presenting, before they present their antigen, they do a little eating first. It's as if macrophages have a bigger belly, so they are better at eating. And dendritic cells have more branches to hang antigen on, so they are better at antigen presenting. Pause and review. Our next tutorial will explain the histology of lymphocytes, which includes the natural killer cells of mono kills granny. And visit helphippo.com for more tutorial videos and flashcards. Help Hippo, better than learning from Wikipedia.